Welcome to Chisholm Trail 61. Today we're doing one of my favorite casseroles of all time. We're going to do a chicken noodle casserole. I'm going to show you how I do that coming up right now. Okay, for our chicken noodle casserole, Dad, first thing we're going to need 2 cans of cream of chicken soup. And it doesn't matter what brand you use or anything like that, just 2 cans of cream of chicken soup. Set this one over here out of the way. We're putting it in a big bowl because we're going to mix quite a bit of stuff together here. So you want to put it in a big bowl. That's 2 cans of cream of chicken soup. To that, we're going to add 1 tablespoon of ranch seasoning mix. To that, we're going to add 1 12-ounce can of evaporated milk. And I'm just going to give that a whisk and get it sort of combined good there. Man, who don't like chicken noodle soup? You know, if you like chicken noodle soup, you're going to love this chicken noodle casserole. We got that combined pretty good. Now, we're going to take our whisk out, but we're going to probably have to go to a spoon. To that, we're going to add 12 ounces of egg noodles. Now, our egg noodles we cooked, we just sort of cooked them al dente. You know, we didn't cook them completely, just cooked them to where they were soft. There goes our oven. Our oven's ready. And we've left them draining over in the sink. And so now we got to get them stirred in here and sort of broke up some. We want to get them mixed up good here. Want to get your noodles all coated well in our sauce there that we made. To that, we got 3 cups of chicken that's cooked. Now I just cut mine up in, you know, half inch to inch pieces there. That's 3 cups. Now you can use rotisserie chicken. You can use your own cooked chicken. What I did, I used 1.5 boneless, skinless chicken breast, and I just seasoned them with salt, pepper, onion powder, and garlic powder on both sides, and put them in the air fryer and baked them in the air fryer at 400 degrees for 35 minutes, and got them so they're completely cooked. I'm gonna stir that in real well. Now what we're going to do, we got 1 cup of frozen mixed vegetables we're going to put in. That's 1 cup. We're going to stir that in. And I know 1 cup of vegetables don't seem like a lot for that much, but you know, you don't want your vegetables to overpower your chicken noodle soup. So that's why you don't use a whole lot of vegetables in it. Just 1 cup of frozen. Now, if you don't have the mixed vegetables, you can use the peas and carrots, or you know, just whatever you like, whatever vegetables you like, or you could actually leave the vegetables completely out of it if you wanted to. But I use 1 cup of mixed vegetables. And like I said, that's the frozen mixed vegetables. And then we're going to put about a half a cup, or I'm sorry, about 1 cup, half of a 12-ounce bag here, or rather 8-ounce bag, half of a 8-ounce bag of shredded cheddar cheese in here. We're going to stir that in good. Man, if y'all could smell this. Now, I didn't show on the video cooking the egg noodles or the chicken because, I mean, no, I didn't want to make it a 30 or 40 minute video. So, but, you know, like I said, you can cook your chicken, just season your chicken however you want, or either you can use rotisserie chicken. You just need 3 cups of chicken, you know, when it's cut up, it's what you need. So you can do that however, and like I said, you cook your noodles, you know, just cook your egg noodles per the directions on the package. Just, you know, cut them short by about a minute or two there when you cook them. I think they said cook in boiling water for like 10 minutes. Do them like 8 minutes, you know, in boiling water, and then they'll be fine. I'm going to push that over to the side and what I got here. I got a 9x13 casserole dish. We're just going to take this, and as best as we can, we're going to just dump this over in here. And just sort of spread it out evenly. Trying to get all of it out that I can. Cause it, all of it is goodness. All of it is flavor. I'm gonna set this over here out of the way. And I'm just gonna sort of spread this out evenly here. Try to get it spread down as even as I can. It ain't got to be perfect, of course. Never will be perfect. But sort of get it pressed down some there. Man, does that ever look and smell good. Shoot, I could eat that just like that. But we ain't done yet. What we're going to do now, we're going to take the rest of this bag of cheese. Because everybody knows you never have too much cheese. We're going to just sort of put us a coat of cheese on top of it here. Be sure we get all of it. I like to get all of it. And what we're going to do there, once we get that on there, we got our cheese sort of spread around there pretty good. We got a 2.8 ounce thing of crispy fried onions, the French's fried onions. We may or may not put them all on there, but we're going to dump us some out here. We can get them coming out. We're going to just sprinkle us some around on there. Add us a little bit of texture to it. I like these fried onions myself. Now you can put whatever type of topping you like on it. Butter crackers, you know, would be good. I like the Ritz crackers. You could do them on it. You know, just whatever type of topping you like would work for it. There's several different ways you could fix the topping. And we got that on there. Get that off my hands there. And I'm going to get me a sheet of aluminum foil here. And I'm going to cut it about the length I want. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to grab my cooking spray here. And I'm just going to give the middle of it a few squirts there. What that'll do, that'll keep it from sticking while it's cooking. That's our tip of the day, which most of you probably know that tip already. I mean, that's no secret there. But in case you didn't, you know, it may be somebody out there that don't know it and has had a problem with whenever they do a casserole and cover it in foil, they go to take the foil off, it's all stuck to the food and it pulls, especially if you got cheese on top of your casserole. That aluminum foil is bad to stick that cheese. And if you do, then you can spray that little bit of that pan spray on your tin aluminum foil, then put it on there and it'll keep it from sticking. But anyway, what we're going to do now, we're going to put this in a 350 degree oven. We got our oven over at 350 degrees. We're going to bake it for 30 minutes. And then we'll take it out and we'll show you what it looks like. Okay, we got our chicken noodle casserole out of the oven there. We're going to take the foil off of it and we're going to take a look at this bad boy here. It's been sitting here about 20 minutes out of the oven, and letting everything come together. We're going to, oh yeah, yeah, she does look good. We're going to get us a little bit of it and we're going to see what it tastes like. I can't wait to get into this. Try to cut me a little bit out, get a little dip out of this corner right here. Man, what you talking about? Just look at there. Look at there at all that goodness. Yeah, buddy. See that cheese stringing? Just look at that. Now, if that ain't good, ain't nothing good. And them fried onions there on top of it just gonna set it off. That just takes it to another level. Let's see, it's gonna be a little warm yet, I know, so I'm gonna blow it a little bit before I take a bite of it. Man, what you talking about? Y'all have got to try this recipe. This is spot on. I mean, complete meal in one dish. You ain't gonna believe the taste. Hey, if you would, give the old video a thumbs up. Like, share, comment, subscribe to our channel. We appreciate all of you do. We appreciate all of you take time every day to watch our videos. Hey, chicken noodle casserole. We'll see you on the next one.